Hey guys, it's Feral. I'm back on Zombiecraft, and I've been doing a little bit of holiday decoration around here. It's not done yet, but I'm going to be turning the base of the What News Tower into a snowman. I've actually encased the outer layer of everything already, all the way up to the top from here, as you can see. And the bigger problem is going to be that I need to actually continue to kind of round things out a little bit. Figure out how I'm going to fit three distinct curves there, but everything is basically just shoved out one block, and I've put the What News text there just in front of where it is on the tower. And I also tried to do a little bit of a custom tree making here. Came out a little interesting. This is not something I do often at all, but trying to make trees, and it came out interesting. We'll just kind of leave it at that. It was originally rounded out a little more, it just didn't look right for the size that it is. But I'm actually not here to record that. Obviously, it's because it's not even done at this point. I'm going to be going over to the Hall of Heroes, and we're going to be picking up a little bit of a something-something. In that we're going to be having the build contest, and it has to be something small in this hall. So Christmas, New Year themed, and just have to figure out what I'm going to make over here. And get a llama, that's not a polar bear. I still actually have in my ender chest the spawn polar bear, and I would just have to put some name tags on it. But anyways, I'm not here for that to discuss what I'm doing, because I still have to kind of figure out what I'm going to do in the first place, and hopefully before I run out of room, because obviously I need to do it sometime soon. Emphasis on Secret Santa. That's going to be the tricky part, because like I said, I want to record it, but at the same time, I keep the name secret, so take a look here. I have to admit, I don't even know where that person lives. I'm gonna kind of do the next best thing that I can do, and that is put together a reed farm. Or not a reed farm, a vine farm. So I'm going to use the design that X used over on Hermitcraft, and we're going to go with kind of a little cross-sectional array that he's got. So I kind of pulled over my starting crop of vines, some basic blocks to get things going. This is going to be a slightly underground farm. There's going to be just a little bit open up at the top so that you can kind of see into it, which I think will make things a little interesting. I think I'm actually going to kind of pare the back wall back a little bit, not make it straight like he has in his videos. And what I'm thinking is, since I've got 64, I can make it 64 wide, so what I'd really like to do is start it here and take it out 64 blocks straight out in this direction, because there isn't anything actually over here currently. Now, I will have a problem with this pond here, potentially, because that's 38 meters away right now, so let's keep going out. We might have to fill that in. How far are we out here? 56. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 should be right here. I should look over there, and I should see 64. Perfect. So that's if I want to cram it into that little space, and I think that's pretty good. I mean, we're not too close to the Enderman build over there, and the path itself, I can also do a little bit of tweaking while I'm over here, is just to kind of spruce it up a little bit. And I can even leave probably at least a few of these trees in here. I mean, I certainly would like to try to avoid taking out that tree if I can. But I want to try to plant some stuff around it so it's not necessarily readily apparent that I've done anything here. So, at any rate, this is where we're going to be starting. I am going to probably go with my top block of red here and set it up so that the top, this would be the back edge of the wall here. Okay, guys, so hopefully that's finished up a little bit of the time lapse I've done there. Obviously, I've got a little more AFKing to do, and I suspect that the farm is not exactly 100% perfect because I went back and rewatched the video. It should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 before we start kicking in. So the downside of this farm is you can indeed actually reach the blocks that are... I know you can't really see it because I've got dark blocks and... whatnot, but you can actually reach this particular row of these two rows, actually, of the vines. However, that is something I am probably not going to worry about just yet, because in all honesty, this is more than big enough that even if you do inadvertently harvest those two rows, you're still going to have the remaining two rows very easy to come back along and from here go up and fix them. So to reiterate how this sort of thing works, you find your spot, you highlight the lowest one on the strand in front of you that you're going to be able to hit, and you take that out, and it's going to drop down along the water, and because of the way that the fences and the water work, you're going to actually see it kind of poke its head out there a little bit. So right there, actually, the way that the block works is the item ends up there, so you just walk by and you pick it up. Not that complex of a farm, very simple, straightforward, and the nice thing about doing it this way is I cheated a little bit when I did this to get all of my starting vines. The downside is if you go into the water like this, you are going to be jumping around like an utter idiot, which is really annoying. That's why I left this end open, so if you do wind up in there, there's a very easy way to get out. And, yeah, not too bad. Okay, so, there you go. That's, 7 stacks of vine blocks. That was my first haul out of the farm. Pretty useful, actually. It's not too bad for, 15 minutes of doing other work in the area. It's gonna take a little while to put this together. I know that, I'm aware of it. And I'm back over here, actually, to continue gathering up stuff. I've already finished up reading what was in all of these chests. I need to go out and get some more lava at this point. And, yeah, also need to start going after some more stone, because as you can see, I'm starting to very quickly drain things. But I've also got to be careful, because now I've burned through most of my efficiency 5 pick on the building over there. I've got my last efficiency pick over there, and my silk touch pick, and that's gonna probably be what this is gonna come down to. Anyways, goal. Just stay clearing, stay clearing, and stay clearing, and do everything I can to gather as much of this stuff out of here as I can. Because this is all going to come in very handy in not having to worry about all this junk in here. Hey guys, it's a perfect time, I think, to go pranking. 'Twas not exactly the night before Christmas, and all through the server, not a creature was stirring, because I'm the only one on. I am over here at my Giftie's base, and I thought I would drop off what I've put together so far. I really had hoped that the gathering on this would have gone a lot faster, but I'm running out of time to do a lot of different things I'm trying to get done before the holiday, especially trying to get the What News Tower done. So I have definitely given what I can here, and just to show you what I've been doing, I have some extra mossy stone bricks that I've given. Lots of stone bricks. This is about 2 harvests of my nether wart block farm, or nether wart farm, and the rest of this stone brick, stone brick, stone brick, and a full shulker box of mossy stone bricks. And as a side bonus, I'm actually going to be giving this person, as an additional gift, I'm going to be putting the vine farm that I built in his name, so it will be identified after him, and the intent is that he will be able to actually go enjoy that vine farm all on his own. Let me do a little bit of extra lighting up here, because it's a little on the... I've already been attacked by one zombie villager at this point, so I want to make sure that anything going on is not going to result in further attacks while he's trying to open up the gift. But yeah, it kind of looks like a giant... I almost wish I could do a giant Yule log here, but there's not really anything I can do for gumdrops or anything on the outside of this, unfortunately. But I'm going to go ahead and put the label on the gift just to let him know that he also has the vine farm as well in spawn, and I think that's actually that's definitely a decent gift, because that's not only a gift to that person, they get the farm named after them, but also the entire server really hopefully will be able to benefit from that farm. I don't know if anyone else has a decent sized vine farm, but I haven't seen any around the spawn area, so hopefully that will come in handy for more than just my giftie here. So anyways, let me go ahead and take care of that, and I will be back with you guys in a little bit. Yeah, we're back here at spawn. I've got 2 things I've got to finish up here before the holidays hits, and of course there is a lot for me to do. First off, I need to decorate this tree. It's going to require popping back to my base for some redstone, some diamond blocks, some gold blocks. I've got a little bit that I can bring over and decorate the tree with. The second thing is I need to complete the What Snowman that I've started off building here and just haven't actually finished, and the reason for that is I can sit there at the snow farm over here all day over by Xander's place, but it's not very efficient. Basically, there's no collection system for what you pick up, so you wind up just filling your inventory with snow, running back over here, and that's pretty much it. So what I'd like to do is actually build something that's going to let me kind of do a little bit of AFKing and hopefully keep a good amount of snow around so that I can build this a little quicker instead of constantly having to come down and enderpearl back up and come down and enderpearl back up. It just really kind of eats up your time pretty darn quickly. I also need to actually go over to my base and bring some dark oak wood over as well, because I need that and a couple other accoutrements that belong on the snowman. But first, obviously, is going to be some sort of snow collection farm. And I'm kind of thinking that my spawn house here might be a suitable location for it, because, well, there's not much here, and because I've got plenty of room underneath me here to work with. Well, the best laid plans of mice and men, well, or I guess the best plans of feral. The trick is I wanted to build it in that little room under there, but I didn't realize that snowmen do not spawn snow when they are at an elevation under 64 blocks. So, what I've done is I've resurrected my very first poke hole down into the ground. This is one I created way back in the early days on the server. In fact, this is my old drop shaft that I did to go straight down. I filled it in the center because there is no water drop in this at all. And I'm going to resurrect it and put it here because this right here at this level is 66 blocks. So I'm going to go ahead and start clearing this out. I'm kind of settling on a design that DocM77 did back in 2014. As far as I'm aware, it should still be valid. However, I'm going to tweak it slightly, I think, if I can pull it off. And we're going to hopefully do it in a way that will reduce lag a little bit, because it does involve a pretty wide open chain of hoppers and whatnot, and that is really something I want to avoid, especially out here near Good Neighbor, because just this being a public area and whatnot, I really don't want to kind of screw things up or make the system too laggy for anyone to enjoy the area. So I had to actually go mining because I don't have any redstone here. And I think I've kind of got a good supply, good cross-section of supplies we're going to need. I think I've got just enough wood to pull this off, but we're going to find out. And I'll let you guys know how this is going to turn out. Well, it didn't quite work out the way I'd hoped, but it's good enough. And it got me just enough snow to get the bulk of it done. I've got some pumpkins down here in case the snowmen ever manage to die off. Just to kind of show you what I've done, I wound up putting a lot of filler blocks around here just to kind of empty my inventory. I was loading things up, and both of my shulker chests are absolutely packed with netherrack from the nether tunnels. And bring it back. I even managed to smelt some nether brick over here since I had some extra coal from all the mining out. What we've got going on here is, as you can see, I've got snowmen. Again, this is based off of a design by DocM77, or at least one that he had up on his channel. On his design, he had the snowman that was up here kind of wedged in the corner spaces of four fences altogether. For the life of me, I can't reproduce that in Minecraft 1.11. I think that's more than likely because of the collision mechanics. If I wanted to try to make it happen, I'd probably have to start doing some stuff with pistons and whatnot, and there's just too much of a chance of it causing the snowman to die. So what we've actually got there is kind of a corner built with the fences, and it turns out that's actually surprisingly good enough. He doesn't seem to want to, and all the time I've been running the farm, he doesn't seem to want to go all the way to the back corner. Now, I know in some cases there are instances where mobs don't want to, they don't want to travel in certain directions. They have a tendency to travel a certain way. You know, they show a tendency or a bias towards going in a specific direction. And I think that's kind of what's happening here, and I may have just kind of lucked out on that. You can see he's up on half slabs, and I've got two fence posts in front here. And just to give you an idea of what's kind of going on behind the scenes here, that's my wiring access, so to speak. I've got redstone going down under here. It's going to be triggered by the pressure plate that I have right in front of the fences. And I've also got a manual trigger method over here in case I need it. There's two pistons out here. They're actually sticky pistons. And they are facing in, and you can just kind of see past the fence here that there are two half slab, there's a double half slab blocks there. And what's going to happen is I'm going to go ahead and step on the piston. It extends, and boom, instant snow. And because of the way that this snow is angled, I can basically just hit both edges. So if the server's not lagging out too bad, I can actually build up a pretty quick supply of snow pretty quickly. Pretty quick supply of snow pretty quickly. Well, it better be quickly. There's a little bit of a glitch with the snowballs that they do that, and the other problem I also have, which is why this little access ramp is here, is some of the snowballs do get stuck. So this is by no means a perfect system. What I've got down here are two exposed hoppers, so the snowballs just drop down into them. They get picked up by the hopper, and there's furnaces underneath part of this, so that way we're not causing any significant hopper lag. And they come over into here, into a double chest system that feeds down into here. All in all, not too bad of a system. It does not work all that quickly, though, as far as emptying out the snow. So what you kind of have to do is mine a little bit, back off and let the snowballs drop down, start mining a little bit more. It's kind of a very cyclical thing. You can't really just sit there and AFK. Also, unlike Doc's design, I don't have any sort of mechanism for dispensing the shovels because, well, this is all a manual drop system. His is sort of regularly cranking the blocks in and out. That was not really an option for duplicating with the resources that I had. This pretty much drained everything for redstone and iron that I had in my starter hut. I don't really don't have much beyond that, unfortunately. So that's kind of the little snow farm I set up. It did pretty good. It managed to get me just enough snow to finish up, and it was certainly a lot quicker than running all the way over, because over by, if you're in the spawn area, there is a snowman set up here for snow, but it's all manual, and there's no hopper collection or anything, so once you fill your inventory, that's it. And even with shulker chests, that was becoming quite a headache to constantly go out and take care of picking up all the snow and crafting it, and then picking up more and crafting it, whereas at least here, yeah, you've got to try not to build up too much of a backlog so that it drains out into the hoppers quick enough before it despawns, but still, it's not too bad. The other thing you also have to watch out for is if you... I'm shift-clicked right now. I'm shifting. If you go forward too far, you're going to wind up going down onto this hopper. So if you are down here, definitely bring some ender pearls. It's definitely going to be necessary in case you fall in. I am back with a final bit of my holiday recording. It has been a long process to get this all done. It has taken quite some time to get everything taken care of. Lots of working away on various bits and bobs and creating actually two new farms to even support what I'm trying to do. And I thought I would start off with a little bit of my final wrap-up on the holidays here, going over what I've built on the server. We're here with the build challenge for the winter holidays, and we're over here on the second floor of the Hall of Heroes, or AKA if you're, I guess if you're British, it's the first floor. There's some amusing disagreement over the exact terminology. But as you can see, I have put together my contribution, which is the Charlie Brown Christmas tree. There's not much room to build up here, folks, so by the time I actually got over here to build anything, there really wasn't any room left. I mean, we've got carolers over there, we've got supposed polar bears, which I'm actually tempted to contribute mine, except the polar bear would probably eat the llama in reality. Looks like we've got some more builds over there from Crystallite and Ukraine. And Pushpot contributed the carolers here, which, yeah, I'd hate to, like, feel sorry for that villager, I really do, that's in there. So there's that, and then I can also show you what else I finished working on, which is going to be over here, just, you know, in the middle of, well, not the middle of, because obviously the Hall of Heroes is in the middle of Good Neighbor, but just off to the side here, you can see that I have decked out the What News Tower in the most derpiest snowman one could ever possibly imagine. I wish I could take no credit for that, because the build just looks... it looks like something more like a Pokey out of one of the Super Mario games than anything else. And I don't know why he's got a bowl of sherbet ice cream on his bounce on his head. Rainbow ice cream up there. The funny thing the thing that amuses me the most is if you look at the letters there carefully enough, that's the what that's actually in the tower, and I brought it further out in the red nether brick. And if you look at it kind of closely, it's either saying what, W-H-U-T, or it is saying V-H-A-T, that. That. So, that kind of amused me. I got the little arms, which are nowhere near where the arms should be. It's like a snow caterpillar, I guess, at this point. And then I also sat down and put together a very rudimentary Christmas tree here. I only had one piece of redstone to contribute to it. Everything else is stuck back at my base. And I have been pretty much going all over the place out here. Just back, a lot of back and forth and back and forth, trying to get coal and other things going on. But I did at least have the diamonds in my chest, or my ender chest, so I have contributed those to this build. Now, the great thing about the What News snowman here is that he's going to be relatively easy to take down. You can see I kind of started trying to build him directly around the tower, which didn't work out very well. So a lot of this is just snow that I'm just going to have to take off, and dirt, which won't take too much else to get rid of either. I did actually also throw in a little bit of a sign for it. I decorated the front yard a little bit too. Not all of it, but today's weather forecast, chance snowman 50%. Or snow beetle or caterpillar or whatever you want to call it now. So we got that. And then, of course, over here on the other side of town, I also have the vine farm that I made for supplying my gift for Ukraine. And that is kind of my first chance at being able to look out from above. I'm not thrilled with the fences up at the top, but in lieu of any sort of better supplies to use on it, it's kind of what I had to go with, unfortunately. Kind of, I wanted to use stained glass, but I completely ran out of that, and yeah, again, time of the essence. I also still have to finish off the stairwell, but I've got some netherrack that's been smelted up that I can start using to finish that job off. So that's kind of what I have done on the server for my holiday theming here on Zombiecraft. So that also coincidentally ties up hopefully the last of the things that I need to do for holiday themed video work. This has kind of thrown me way behind because I was also, I got torches stuck up there. I'll just have to live with that. I've got only a little bit of snow left at this point. I've been up and down all evening just getting enough to finish off the back of this thing. And it's not a 100% perfect build anyways. You can see I skimped on some snow on the bottom layer there because no one is going to be seeing it unless they're flying. And, you know, snow is of the essence, unfortunately. So yeah, that's probably going to be the end of the holiday videos for now. I will catch you guys in the next video, and thanks for watching.